Ramona Radio. It's a lot going on in the government right now. We shutting back down. All I gotta tell y'all, man, is follow the glick, bro. Address me as political prisoner Vince Staples. I'm out here fighting for you. What you fighting for? Shout out the park. You know the platform. You know the intentions. We got a lot to talk about today. I really hope you're ready. Ramona Radio. Shout out Luke. You see he bringing my Postmates on a bicycle. It's July, whatever day it is when it's air. 2020. How's everybody feeling?
I'm good.
Yeah, why'd you hesitate, bro?
What's up with you, man?
Yeah.
I'm just trying to think of other words for good. Wow. I'm fantastic. Thank you.
Yeah, I like that. Lovely. Fantastic. Lovely. Is good. Great. Have you seen the Fantastic Four?
Yes.
Who's your favorite member of the Fantastic Four?
The redheaded one.
The fire dude or the rock dude?
The rock dude. Oh, yeah.
Thing. Ben Graham.
Did you know the Fantastic Four is a metaphor for the black family?
What?
Y'all want to get into that or
yeah,
what?
Yeah, get into that.
Name him. Give me the character.
Mr. Fantastic.
He's the one that overextends himself to the community.
Right.
He's always helping out, but you can't help a nigga that don't want to help themselves.
Okay. Invisible girl.
She's hiding from her true self. That's the light skin, the colorist light skin.
Oh, the mulats.
The human torch.
Human torch? That's the shooter. Keep going.
And then the thing.
Crackhead uncle.
Oh.
Wow.
That all makes sense.
And they all fighting supremacy and oppression, but they don't know they part of the system.
The four.
Doom was definitely a hyper-capitalist for sure. Real meanie.
He on one of them labels. I be taking the pub.
That's why his show wasn't successful.
All of them.
And then you see Disney try to whitewash it with the Incredibles and make the family wholesome.
Sam Jackson was in there, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
He also wore blackface to Django.
I didn't like that character.
He also brought his own blackface to Django.
That story's fire.
What do you mean?
Jamie Foxx told him not to put that blackface on.
I think this is a public story. I think
he darkened his face or what?
So yeah, but they came to Django. Jamie Foxx should have been set on Django and Samuel Jackson was in full blackface and Jamie put him to the side. I was like, hey, look, man.
Like with the burnt cork?
Yeah, to make himself a little bit more menacing, I could think, was his point. But it was a bad idea.
And Jamie Foxx was like, hey, man, don't do that. Don't let them do that to you. And he was like, nah, this was my idea.
Yeah, that was
I like that. He was like, nigga, I'm about to clean up, bro. This shit is dead.
Quentin called. We got to make it happen.
Yeah, Quentin fat ass eating quesadillas and shit.
It's all a conspiracy, bro.
Like, yeah,
The people don't know it's a conspiracy, bro, which leads us to this week we just had.
Right. You exposed a lot.
Man.
Good job.
I really care about our people, bro. We got to know, man. Why they want to take you out to the ball game, Ty? What they trying to distract
so
you
So they
from?
Can laugh at you eating them Dodger dogs, nigga. Shit's like...
Buy me some peanuts and
I'm not even finna tell niggas the length on them things, bro. Shit is vicious, bro. This shit is different. This shit is devious.
Yeah, it's a 30 round in that thing, man. What's the most shells you ever had? What's the most rounds you ever had in a glizzy, Mia?
What are you asking me?
Oh, you heard the question now.
What's the most rounds you ever had in a glizzy? Like, what's the biggest glizzy you ever had in your life?
Whatever's average.
You're from Chiraq, ain't you?
But I don't eat.
You're from the South Side, ain't you?
I know, but I don't.
You ain't never
like
had
that.
No Portillo's with the extended clip.
Once in high school, one time.
So you had a 30 round.
But
glizzy.
I can't.
Or was it 15 in the clip?
Just one.
But was it 15 rounds or was it 30 round? How long was the glizzy?
How were you dressing to Frank Mueller?
everything but mustard. I told y'all I don't eat mustard.
Okay.
So you put relish on the Frank Ocean, but you didn't want no.
You know,
mustard.
not relish either, but like the slice of pickle, the whole thing, not like it diced.
Oh, that
up.
Little
that's
wedge
too,
that they just put in the cut. That's some Chicago shit.
So you put the pickle wedge in your Francis?
Yes, on the side. I put it on the side like you just slide it in.
It on the side.
Was it tomato? Yeah.
Yes, all that.
Oh.
You like the Cubs or the White Sox?
White Sox.
So you don't
the
win.
I hate the Cubs. I hate Wrigleyville.
That's the right answer. That's the right answer.
It's like another version of hell.
Rig rhymes with nig, and nig is short for nigger. So I don't know if I don't think that they're.
Sure.
I don't think that they're a black friendly organization. You seen what happened to Sammy Sosa, right?
I did. It's very unfortunate.
He did that to himself.
They made him hate himself and love their wealth.
Talk
that shit.
Feel me?
That's why Shorty holler where the ballers at. Drug dealer buys Jordan, crackhead buys crack. And a white man gets paid off for all of that.
True.
But we not gonna act holier than now or I'm on the radio. We gonna make sure y'all have a good time. Great beat tag.
Bring in the acai bowl.
Shout out Long White. Shout out Sex. Shout out Shock Lizzie. Ramona Radio, we had to take a quick break. I got a burger in my mouth. But Mia just told us we need to go to Honey Kettle.
I didn't say that.
What you say?
I was asking about it.
Yeah, but that also about? Insinuated maybe we didn't, you know.
No, I wasn't trying to push y'all on nothing. I don't know nothing out here. I was asking for some insights.
On some chicken?
No, you said y'all should go to Honey Kettle.
I did not say that. I wish it was recording.
I think
you're lying.
We'll rewind. We'll get the play back.
I was just looking for some insight. You don't have to shame me.
What you
want to
know? Let's talk about it.
Humbly asking.
What you want to know, Mia?
What's up with it?
Mia forgot she was in a house where all of us were eating Honey Kettle.
That's a fact.
And she didn't get none.
I didn't get any. It was too much going on.
You were shy?
No.
You were shy, Glizzy?
No, it was just.
You was mad I didn't have hot dogs at the crib, bro?
No,
that's what it
sounded
like.
40 bottles of champagne, a lot of firecrackers.
Now you're telling.
Now, what?
Yeah, relax.
It was a celebration.
Fireworks are illegal, Mia.
Here?
Yes.
Mia, let's talk, okay?
My bad. I didn't know.
Let's talk. No, Mia, let's talk.
Okay. Let's talk. Okay.
Got a quick question. What's your favorite fruit?
Mango.
What's your favorite vegetable?
Spinach.
What's your favorite part of the chicken?
The leg. Dark meat.
You're not ready to have this conversation with us.
Why? Because I don't like
all
white
three
meat?
All three of them was wrong.
Because I don't like white meat,
you're
so dry.
You're supposed to like the titty.
It's dry.
Not a Honey Kettle.
You want to eat dry ass chicken and biscuits?
You ain't never had shit.
Who's making dry ass chicken,
and dry breast biscuits? What are you talking about?
I've never had a moist piece of white meat.
Mia be swallowing Popeye's biscuits. Yeah. Dry ass shit.
I don't know. I'm open, you know?
Just go to the Kettle.
But you had your opportunity at my birthday and you
didn't
touch nothing. Because you thought I came to my house with some dry ass chicken. That's
Wow. You thought he? Well, I just
you walked
that.
Into the black man's house.
You thought he was
house.
Celebrating his birthday with dry chicken?
No.
Like, I can't even trust this nigga.
I looked at it too and I was like, oh, this is great. But I just wasn't.
Kind of shitting on your birthday.
I just wasn't.
You ain't hit her crunch. You ain't hear people eating. You didn't hit her crunch.
Actually, I didn't see anybody eating around me. I just.
That's crazy because when I walked in,
I
heard a whole lot of crunch.
I was just zoned out.
But the whole family box was gone.
It was gone.
But you didn't see not one person eating.
No.
Or hear not one crunch.
No.
But you remember seeing the chicken.
I remember seeing a.
Do you remember seeing the chicken?
Extra large box of chicken. It was like a one side, it had 400 pieces of chicken, and then it had fries on the other side.
Honey Kettle shitting on Harold's.
And then when you left, probably, was the chicken gone?
Yes, and the fries.
And you didn't see nobody eat?
I see nobody eat.
Wow.
That means it's amazing, Mia. Let me ask you a question. Who has the best chicken in Chicago?
I know you want me to say Harold's or something. No. Okay.
You can say Uncle Remus.
Because it is.
It's Uncle Remus.
Oh. It is. But because I like, they got that mumbo style sauce. Mm-hmm. And I'm more.
That shit's busting.
I'm more of a fan of that than I am regular mild sauce.
So you eat your chicken for the sauce and not the chicken itself?
Yes.
We getting to the bottom of it now.
Do you know where mumbo sauce come from?
DC.
Full drink on a carpet.
Shout out Relish. Free Tech K. Shout out Chick-fil-A.
What up, bro?
You are on the radio. You live on Ramona Radio. You want to say something to the people?
Shout out to Cherry Bloom. That's myself. Shout out to all the homies from the set. R.I.P. Lil Half. R.I.P. Johnny. I should freestyle. Drop a little bar for you, but I don't know.
Go ahead.
Run that up.
Look. I'm on your head like Swamp Blue times two. I'm much worse than that. I'm shooting head and shoulders. Yeah, better bounce back. Retaliation is a must. When they see me, they say, he's a plus. Girls want to date me, take me on dates. If I don't pay for dates, I usually say okay. Right. And buy and hide, whatever that means. And chuck up the deuce.
Bro, really Northside Jadakiss. Yeah, that's hard.
He just hung up after that one.
Just, yeah. I'm out of here.
Wow. Look, man, it's a lot of talent on the Northside. It's a lot of talent on the Northside. Speaking of talent, Do y'all think, right, that y'all think August Alsina was on the set of Bad Boys 3?
Nah.
You mean Bad Boys for Life?
Yeah.
I mean Bad Boys 3.
He actually, yeah.
That's different.
It's different.
That's different.
I mean, you never know with the universe and the way that things transpire.
Yeah. You think it was that Men in Black too?
You think he was on Independence Day?
Little baby August? He was probably young as shit, bro. Are you crazy?
He was a little kid from Independence Day.
They groomed him like that.
Yeah, that's a good possibility, bro.
It's a good possibility.
Them odds is crazy. I'm betting that in Vegas, bro.
These niggas is betting on this one.
The accusations. This
you
is
don't think he
wild.
Was one of the flower children when Will was at the talent show?
How much
show?
You want to bet him to cut this part out? Them niggas tweaking, bro. What the fuck is going on, bro?
Oh, shit.
Mia.
Yes.
You're Jada Pinkett Smith.
Right.
You're a mother. You're a wife. You're an activist.
True.
You're an actress.
Mm-hmm.
You are a frontman of a rock band.
Mm-hmm.
You are a Buddhist.
Mm-hmm.
You are a counselor.
Mm-hmm.
You are a life coach.
Mm-hmm.
The side hoes start talking reckless. Do you try to speak to them on the red table talk?
No, it's nothing to be said.
Or do you pull up with that thing?
There's nothing to be said, honestly. Mm.
Let me know how you feel.
You got to off them. We had an agreement. We had a bond. Now, no, man, I can't trust you. It's nothing to be said. You gotta go.
Public
whatever
execution.
Whatever that means.
Is it public or is it private execution?
On Facebook Live?
With
I'm
that?
With the hot dog fever?
With that decapitator?
You like the mess?
Yeah, just do it publicly.
Public.
It's fine.
Okay.
I'm okay with that. I don't see no problem with that.
So, are you thinking like a guillotine?
Bring that back?
Are you thinking a hanging?
I was like, stone. Probably.
Stone the side piece?
Mm. So you're stoning the side piece. What kind of rocks are you using? Or are you using crystals for the balance of the universe? Because you are Jada Pinkett Smith.
Yeah, we can keep it spiritual.
And just realign a nigga's chakras.
Real quick.
Okay.
I like that.
What's those rocks that they be doing? The salt rocks? What's the...
That's that shit that God turned Locke wife into, right? What kind of rock do you think they moved to get Jesus out the tomb? Was it a dirt rock?
That was like a stone.
How big was that rock?
You dissing hoods right now, or are you talking about the actual rock?
Like, what?
That's funny.
I'm talking about the Bible.
Oh.
He didn't answer that question, though.
Yeah. I mean, ain't nobody from Bedrock Universe. And if they are, they can't afford Apple Music, so we straight.
Ramona Radio! Top five goatees in entertainment, sports and entertainment. Go.
That Lindsay.
Walk in the studio.
Everybody clap it up. Lindsay's here.
Hey, Lindsay.
Welcome, Lindsay. Welcome, Lindsay.
Oh, she got cupcakes.
Lindsay, top five goatees in sports and entertainment right now. Into the mic.
Stone Cold.
Stone Cold is top two.
Stone Cold.
Okay, so Mia, that's your choice. Who's your choice, Corey?
The Rock.
Okay, that was lazy. Lakin, who's your top five? Just give me one. We add it to the five.
Mm. When Shaq had the goatee.
Absolutely. Mm. I was going to say Dr. J.
Did Dre have a goatee?
No,
Dr. J.
Oh, I was about to say.
No.
Oh, Will Clyde Frazier.
That's a good goatee.
Yeah, Will Clyde Frazier for sure.
Matt Barnes' goatee is up there.
Oh. He for sure pulled up on D-Fish.
To be honest, mine is Derek Fisher. Not even close. Because he rocked goatee with bald head.
Shaq did too.
Yeah.
Nah. Shaq was bald. Derek Fisher was balding. It's different.
Why would you want a bald head and a bald face?
Who has bald head with bald face?
Michael Jordan.
Nah, he had facial hair.
He had stash.
I mean, but
not really though.
Yeah, I don't know. That shit was thin, I can't really tell though.
All Michael Jordan had was eyebrow, bro. Eyebrow, some stubble.
Oh, chuckle.
Charles Barkley, bald face, bald head.
Nah, he had the mustache.
That's later in life.
He had the mustache.
But he had a meatball head.
Meatball head.
He had a head shaped like a meatball.
Charles Barkley looked like he'd get drunk and beat his kids.
He looked like he got a soft stone.
I thought he was talking about hot dogs today, bro. This is fucked up.
When did you first realize that you shouldn't be eating a chili dog?
I never had a chili dog. I'm going to put that out there. Too much. That's a lot, to be honest with you. And I never planned on having one either. So there's that.
So are we going to Earl's, guys?
Earl's. Yeah, we're going to Earl's.
Lindsay, you never been to Earl's?
I've never had a chili dog.
Oh, I feel that.
I've never had chili outside of a bowl.
You've never had chili cheese fries?
Never.
You never had a chili?
Never. I just said not out of a bowl with nothing else in it.
She raised her voice too.
She's embarrassed. She's ashamed.
I'm not.
You should be ashamed.
I make grade A chili.
How you make grade A chili? You don't put it on nothing. Stop.
Put it on your dads.
Stop. Put it on the dads. Put it on the guys.
Put it on the fork.
Put it on the fork.
I'll put it on a knife that I make top tier chili.
The fork. Put it on everybody.
Put it on Larry. The six, nigga.
Okay. Yeah. I put it on Larry.
All right.
On Larry. I make top tier chili, hands down. I'll die for it.
So on Black Market Vintage, they're selling an ebony cookbook, and there's a ham on the cover.
Yeah, that's out.
Is that white supremacy?
Absolutely.
For sure.
Yeah.
Tyler Page, can you do me a favor? Grab a mic, let's talk.
Here you go.
Speak for your people.
The rep.
What's up?
Tyler Page is a white male. He's not really that white. He doesn't know any white people. He has no white friends. He did not grow up with white people. But he's tall and he's white enough. So we go to him for cultural, you know, discrepancies. Do you like ham?
Hell no.
Is ham a staple or a fixture in the white community?
Consider Christmas dinner something a staple, then yeah, but that's about all.
What have you seen more of? Ham, meatloaf, or turkey?
Meatloaf for sure.
Thank you, Tyler Page. You can give the mic back now.
The whites have spoken.
That was very insightful.
So my correspondent let us know a few things. So I want to know where the ham came from, who honey baked it, and why we still eat it today. I'm on the radio.